Ooh, I love that new music. Right, time to begin. I have my coffee. I'm all ready to go. I have been waiting for this game since it got announced. Greener. Gotta calibrate it because it's a thingy game, isn't it? A rhythm game. Yeah, that's way wrong. There we go, zero millisecond audio latency apparently. That'll do. Show UI, show subtitles. Yeah, that's fine. So, they're gonna be difficulty levels, aren't they? These are all equipped, already equipped. In we go then.
The first hell was Vogue, full of cold and ice and despair. Unknown didn't care though, she had her own plan.
So we're called Unknown.
Starts the murder parade. I reckon we'll see lots more of her. Hey!
trying to work out the weapon switching and stuff at the moment. It is a bit. But I keep fucking up the reason. I'm going to tell it to try the calibration again.
Crystal nearby somewhere.
It's like Devil May Cry, so the music improves as your rating goes up. And that literally works as a teleport, nice.
Night. as a liquidy split.
So this is literally to keep you on rhythm, this thing. Slowly getting the hang of it. So this little skull thing is to like keep your multiplier up outside of combat. Sword is where I'm failing at the moment. And the fact that I can dodge. So you're going to hit the executions on beat as well. Everything has to be on the beat. Yeah, getting hit reduces your multiplier, so every time I'm going to the sword, I'm getting hit by one of them, and it's going down again.
Harper and Vogue gave me knowledge of myself. My ultimate, I guess you could say.
They're getting used to moving while keeping beat.
Should get it next time.
I think it's a different song by the way. Yeah, it is keeping the beat while fighting, which is the really difficult bit. This looks like a boss arena. Sounds like we get special boss music.
Thank you.
Haven't heard that one.
They got me. Last bit of my health. Right. Oh, so you're gonna do it again. Oh well. Gotta do better this time.
The first hill was Vogue.
Yeah, we've seen this bit. So when you miss a beat, your multiplier goes down. Your multiplier affects your damage. So that multiplier at the top of the screen. So when I'm on beat, that goes up, means I do more damage as well. So that one times isn't just like points multiplier, it's a damage multiplier as well. And if I get hit, that goes down. Execution works like the ones from Doom, so you've got to get that to get health back and stuff. Those green crystals give health back as well. and then this is for like ranged attacks and maintaining your modifier when you're out of combat. So yeah, if you could stay on beat. You could do way more damage. So it's just easier. Still pushing the execute spot. Get in there.
Yeah.
that mess up lickety split.
That sword super is way better than yours.
Demons will lie, then they rally with a cross.
She got angry. They got me. She tried bastards. Again. Right, boss fight again. Let's see if I can survive this time. I have always first boss down, quite messy. Defeating the boss revealed the path to a new hell. New torments. Defeat the boss with the new torments. Conquer them to earn sigils. New hit streak boon. Enduring fury boon slows down the rate at which your fury drops. Once your hit streak reaches 6. Cool. How far down the leaderboard am I? 32,443rd. Continue. So what are these torments? Gain extra damage just by killing demons on the beat. So torments are like hard mode versions of it. And you get extra rewards. So yeah, you do that one, you get Street Guardian. Do that one, you get ammo boost. Do that one, you get faster hit streak boosts. And then we have Hell 2, which is Stygia. This is the arch enemy one. So you're going to my primary. I don't have any sigils unlocked yet, do I? No. Oh well.
I told you she'd sing again. Killing that bit of the judge gave her some of her voice back. Gave us both a chance to get back what we'd lost. Rip it from the judge, a piece at a time. Judge didn't much care for that, though. So she called up the strongest devils to her throne. One after another they came. To form a council of war, they called it. Now whether the council believed in us, in the threat we posed, I mean, truth is, not yet. We were still.
I think the skull thing you carry around is meant to be the narrator as well.
Bottom line was, they were dealing with something angry. Something that was coming for them. And something they did not know how to stop. Before anything, the judge wanted answers. You see, some poor devil once told the judge that he destroyed this old skull, ground him into dust. And just so we're being clear, that old skull is me.
Yeah.
Malachi, Malachi, you swore the skull had been destroyed.
Hell 101. Lie, but don't lie to the judge. You gotta be done for that. Then again, this joker here, well, let's just say somewhere a village was missing their idiot.
It reminds me of the narrator from Sebastian.
This damn soul,
like the jokes he tells and stuff.
Shall be your only war. My aspects will guard the other hands. She must never be allowed to reach the throne. Sure, never. Tell me you hear me.
Yes, the skull's attack deals low damage but weakens enemies. Alyssa White Goose from Arch Enemy.
Like it was yesterday. Wish I didn't.
that's a voice I recognise.
Kind of electricity.
ready for us. At least they tried to be. Just getting warmed up.
Just as I must be. Loving these revolvers. Yeah.
Judge's second aspect just went first. The judge was an awful sore injury.
There is a multiplier, I've never seen one.
Ride the lightning!
Yeah, I am loving them pistols. Hi, Greg. So, I am slowly getting into the rhythm of it. I've unlocked a couple of weapons. So you start off with like a little skull. This is Metal Hellsinger. It is basically a cross between Doom and a rhythm game. 55%. I did better that time. So, all your weapons do shit damage unless you hit stuff on the beat. The more you hit stuff on the beat, you get a multiplier. The multiplier gives you more points and makes you do more damage. And then it has the Doom thing where you can execute enemies for like health and ammo. So I've done Voke, which is the first one. I've done Stygia. And with each of these that you do as well, unlock Torments, which is like a challenge mode. So you can see this one. You gain extra damage boosts by killing demons on the beat. So not only have I got to hit stuff on the beat, I've got to get my actual kills on the beat as well. But if I manage to do that, I get a perk that protects my hit streaks. So I've just done Stygia. And that's unlocked these ones, so yeah, so there we go. The downside to that one is I'm going to defeat waves of behemoths, which are big enemies that take a lot of damage, and I lose weapons one by one as I'm doing it. But once I've got that, my fury, which is your multiplier, can't go below a certain amount. So these are like challenges. But the things that I've just unlocked. So that's the sword that you start with, the Unknown's Blade. That does a hell of a lot of damage, but you're in melee range. And if you get hit, your multiplier goes down as well, and you've got a health bar, so you can die. You got Paz, which I'm guessing is short for Pazuzu. He is your maintainer. So if you're on a like an area where there's only a couple of enemies and you want to maintain your multiplayer, you can use him, or you can just use him to fire on the beat when you're out of combat to maintain your multiplayer. We got Persephone, which is a shotgun, and it can hit multiple things at once. And then you've got the things that I've just got, which are amazing, which are terror revolvers, which have infinite ammo. They don't work at very long distances, but they have an ultimate ability which spawns basically a shadow version of yourself that keeps shooting things. So while we're on this bit, I am going to be right back because I need blue. I'll be with you in a second. I'll leave you with a cool music. Right, I'm back. On to the next level. So, we've done Stygia. One Yelm. Oh yeah, you can see the top players on the leaderboard as well. So... oh, it's not showing it for that one. Oh well. Oh, it's because it's an option. So... there is me. Top 10. FNF Doom. I do know Shroud was at the top of one of these leaderboards at one point. But Yelm it is. So a lot out. I don't have any sigils, but we're going to have our pistols because they're awesome. So the sword and the skull you always have. Everything else is optional.
Well, it went the way the judge didn't want it to go. Stygia fell. The unknown got back more of her voice, and I... well, I got back a bit more of what I'd lost. Hallelujah.
Yeah, I'm willing to bet that Paz is short for the Pazuzu.
It was just a
which is the demon that's in,
from a long, long time ago.
The Exorcist.
Like I said,
the demon that takes over the little girl.
No one remembers. Or if they do, just enough to make them suffer. It was all coming back to me. Judge sent every scholar in the hell to see what they could learn about the unknown.
This prophecy of yours turned to use the relevant.
Prophecy. I might do these challenge modes off stream. I do them in Discord or something when I'm bored. Because they look difficult.
Yeah, Ginger. We're waiting on us and Yelm, our next port of call, but at least at
Ginger
the start.
Is a good band. I had the opportunity to see them live once and I missed it.
Smart money is probably not on us, but who don't love an right. Underdog?
So, pistols have infinite ammo. Switch to Paz. There we go. Everything. to get it dead centre, it looks like. Oh no, him for his arm.
Wobbles out, puking acid, the worst.
New weapon, crossbow.
Breaker of soul.
Corrupt out of gold. I died. Those green things get me every time. I think I got one during the last boss fight, and that was it. Manner. I'm trying to concentrate. Sorry, I'm not talking much. I'm not good at keeping on with it.
Statues left standing in the cathedral.
Well, yeah, it's a bit like BPM. You've got to keep on the beat with your gunshots, with your melee swings, with your little skull thing. The higher your multiplier is, the more damage you do and the more points you get, and the better the music is. But it's really difficult to keep it on beat sometimes because the beat does change. But I'm enjoying it. And then this little skull dude is called Paz, and he's both the narrator and what you use to maintain your multiplayer outside of combat. Although, if you see little pots and stuff like that around, you can break them. Up your multiplier.
Truth is, I still can't set foot in the church. Not because I'm not allowed, just because, well, I'm a skull.
And it has like an execute like Doom as well. So that execute gives you ammo back if you're using one of the weapons that only has ammo. And it gives you health back guaranteed every time. Also supposed to reload on beat as well. You also have to do those executes on beat. Oh, my friend.
Thanks.
each weapon has an ultimate which I'm going to get to use in a sec. Each of the weapons has their own super as well. So if you use the skull, it like charges up as you use it, so you can have all of them ready at the same time, technically, if you can organize it that way. But the skull one does like lightning that freezes stuff, and then if you execute them while they're like that, they explode.
Nothing like an endless stare to really hammer home.
The sword has one where you just go crazy with it. The gun summons another unit that, like, also shoots at sneak people. Like, the crossbow that I've got and not currently using does, like, a black hole that draws stuff in. And the shotgun that I don't have equipped because I don't like it does basically, like, a big fire blast. Those guys with the shields are my bane at the moment, so I can't work out a way around their shield. You do way less damage if you're like offbeat when you hit stuff as well. Red crystals as well, if you shoot them, you do a massive explosion. Usually kills everything nearby or comes close to it. And then the green crystals are healing, but you have to get close to them
and hopefully
pick up the shards. yet, you can get frozen. Yeah, that was the sword super. You're back. Yeah, you've got to dash as well. And if you can dash on the beat, cooldown comes back on it instantly. That area done. Occasionally, if you're lucky as well, there's like tokens around that can either move you up a level on your multiplier, or they can put you straight up 16 times if you're really lucky.
Just hoping I'd get him before the unknown shanked all of hell in the process.
Right, this will be a boss fight. Fun. Right, how do we get past the armor? Explosives. Let's go. Is good if you've got Xbox Game Pass. I don't know if there's a PC version of it, but if there is, you might be able to play it. Now she calls him friends. A pixel of health.
Unknown heard the music now. There was still more to do.
Resurrect. Sweet. at you. Yeah, if you've got enough points, you can use some to resurrect. But you can only do it twice, three times. So yeah, if you've got Xbox Game Pass, have a look, see if it's got a PC version available for it. So fires a bolt that explodes an in-point dealing area damage, deals more damage if fired on a beat. Bend the laws of physics line, you shouldn't leave it to guarantee itself. Yeah, so that's the crossbow that I got. Sweet. Yeah, I know it's available on PS5, it's just... if you have Game Pass, you don't have to buy it then. There you go, I spent just under half my time at full bonus. And I am 20,305th in the world. So yeah, these are like the challenge modes available. So slay demons with ultimate attacks to satisfy this torment. So yeah, you're going to use your ultimates to win. Incostis, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Another 5 levels. So, let's go and have a look at a couple of these then. For killing with rhythm. Get extra damage boost by killing demons on the beat. Let's see what this is
before
like.
Before we go on, let me tell you about sigils. You see, back in the day, there were 7 archdevils that served the judge, the 7 sovereigns. They did this silly little thing called a coup. Best to not dwell on it, but as punishment, they got chopped up and cast across the hells. Thing is, they only got mostly killed, you see. Because the hate the dead 7 held for the judge lived on in the sigils hidden in the realms of torment. Whoever managed to best these torments and gain those sigils, why, they'd be walking away scot-free with infernal power. For most folk, that's just a temptation too great to pass up.
So, I'll do a few of these challenges,
like I was
and then
saying,
that'll be
this
done.
Tormented realm was formed by the death of Amducius, a fairly whimsical archdevil. As archdevils go, I suppose. Fella tried to march to his own drum, which is not really a winning strategy in hell. But, what do you know, it worked for him. Whoever wanted to get past him, why, they'd need to overpower his music. And as you might have guessed... most souls just can't.
So, we got set weapons. Gonna kill 40 demons on the beat. Hits on the beat deal extra damage.
I mean, make an omelet, break a few eggs, right?
So. So we only start with 10 seconds. So you can tell when you're on beat because it's the light damage, but I don't like the shotgun.
she's got this. She ain't gonna stop
now. It's gonna take a fair bit of practice. Wonder if I have access to any of the other ones. Archdevil controls which weapons you wield.
So this realm was created by the
I quite like
Artemis,
it, Brina.
The most capricious, change-minded, flaky, and unpleasant, unstable member.
Well, you can tell where they've got some of their ideas from, like
folks
with the
play by his rules,
the music changing with the beat and with your multiplayer is straight out of Devil May Cry. But it feels a lot like Doom, like the rhythm of.
And you
like, I know.
Not resist.
Once you get to a certain amount of abilities and weapons in Doom, that's got its own rhythm to it. And this is the same. So. Yeah, this could be fun. That one was easy. So first two attacks of switching weapons don't use ammo. Cool. So there's weapon trickery 2 there. I need to do that. That upgrades it. Relics that you do then. Faster hit streak runes. Golden relics breathe against the power of Alphas. Alphas are really upstairs when everything's cut out that way. If you don't know, but we collected relics and those are not harmless relics or all those things. No idea what this means.
This realm here was built by the expiration of Alphas. This guy, see, he didn't start out as an archdevil, no, more like an infernal cockroach, if I'm being charitable. But he was smart, and above all, greedy. This fella collected powerful relics, and with those, he rose up to power. Now, you make some smart choices in his realm, for he will not let his power go easily.
Kill 50 demons, use the relic pickups to temporarily boost your damage, ultimates, and ammo.
Thank you. We all struggle sometimes. She just got to get back up.
Oh, I got to 39. What other ones have we got? Giant Slayer. Beat Waves, Behemoth. Boom. Enjoy things one by one. Right, this could be fun.
Well, this realm was formed by the death of Boone, the most spiteful of the dead seven archdevils. He didn't have a lot of fans, let me put it that way. Souls who wander into this realm lose everything they got and have to defend themselves with just their own hands. If they got hands, that is.
Ooh, no health and executions. No help on executions. Let's try it again. Oh, I only need to kill 10 of them. Which we'll start with. Only got my sword.
Oh,
Idiot. Yuri can never drop below two to... Oh, that's a good one to get if I can get it multiple times. So if I do Giant Slayer multiple times, my Fury can never go below a certain amount. Denies you any healing, however the closer you are, the stronger you will become. There you go.
This realm of torment was created by the death of Morax, most selfish of the dead seven archdevils you ever did see. Guy just would not give his subjects anything, which was, to be fair, consistent for an archdevil in hell. Starving, they now roam this hell in hordes in search of anything to consume.
Right, I've got my pistols. All I really need. They're gonna kill 99 demons. B, please. I have failed at being on beat for this one though. That's more like it.
Still more to do.
Oh, I made it to 80. Wasn't far off. Right. I am going to head off now because I need to go and get food and stuff. I might try and get the that killing with rhythm done while I'm off stream. But yeah, this is me done for now. I am loving this game. It's great. The music and it's brilliant as well. No worries, Bart. IRL stuff is more important. Always. So no need to apologise. I just need to find somebody to raid now. Who is on? Who is a boot? Yeah, it took me a while to make these. I'm making some more at the moment as well for another spooky game. We will go and raid Truer because I've just seen he's still online. Yeah, so it is a fun game, man. I'm loving it. Try it out if you get the chance. It might hurt your hands after a while, though. Mine are aching a little bit at the moment. So I will see you all soon. If any of you interested, my buddy Dave Haggard Badginger is having a stream tomorrow as well. And it's going to be me, him and his wife putting together and painting Gundam models. And probably getting shouted at for being bad at it. So drop by and say hello if you want. But otherwise, I'll see you next week. Bye everybody. Bye bye.